The official launch date for Flight 11 has been announced following the recent test of spacecraft 38. If all goes according to plan, it will be sooner than anticipated. Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. We have now reached the final test for Flight 11, which prominently showcased the exceptional performance of spacecraft 38's six engines. No issues were encountered during or after the test, strongly indicating that the assessment was a complete success. With that milestone achieved, attention turns to the next crucial question: when is the flight scheduled to take place? The surprising answer came immediately after the engine test. The U.S. Coast Guard issued a notice to local mariners confirming that the launch time was set for October 6th to October 12th. The daily launch window was extended from 23 hours 15 minutes UTC to 1 hour 22 minutes UTC the following day. For those using Central Standard Time, this means a start time of 6:15 p.m., optimal for viewing the crucial ascent and descent stages. The timeline has been carefully planned to enhance observation, analysis, and data collection based on additional documentation. October 6th has been set as the primary launch date, with the remaining days designated as backup opportunities. SpaceX is expected to issue an official statement soon via X and their website confirming these specific dates. If your initial prediction aligns with this time frame, you can comment with F11 to indicate your participation. Once your prediction is refined, you can provide a final estimate for the actual launch date. If the flight takes off soon after the 6th, the mission will be less than 2 weeks away. However, this depends on how smoothly preparations go, as SpaceX has several opportunities within this time frame. One important thing to keep in mind is that this schedule will prevent SpaceX from surpassing the 37-day completion record set between flights 5 and 6. But at this point, speed is not the primary objective. Success is paramount. That record will eventually be surpassed, but the company is currently prioritizing reliability above all else. This gives them more than a week to complete any outstanding tasks. The initial action will involve moving Ship 38 back to the production facility. Road closures have been planned from midnight to 4 a.m. on the 24th to facilitate this move.
Preparations for the ship's transport are complete, and S-38 has been unloaded from the landing pad. The craft will then be moved directly to Mega Bay 2. Engineers will conduct a comprehensive reliability assessment inside Mega Bay 2. The engines, which have recently faced significant stress during testing, will be given priority. Proving their stability is crucial to eliminate potential failure risks, ensuring reliable performance from launch to landing. One particular engine, called the C-lay, will be a particular focus. This engine will need to be reignited in space, a significant challenge especially since it has never undergone a self-reignition test before. The next component to be evaluated is the heat shield. This device has withstood the high temperatures, vibrations, and pressures during testing. S-38 has a more comprehensive setup than previous models, with key improvements such as the implementation of a crunch-wrap design. This assessment will determine whether the heat shield can withstand the extreme conditions it will face during re-entry and will also identify any issues that require resolution. Additional systems, including the payload bay, fuel tank, wrapped composite pressure vessel, tail flaps, and fuel lines, will also be inspected. Insights from previous missions indicate that defects similar to those identified before the 10th flight should be avoided. Once this evaluation is complete, SpaceX will proceed with the installation of the payload integration system and the flight termination system. The B-15 Super Heavy is in solid condition. It has completed the installation of its hot stage and likely also the setup of its own flight termination system. This indicates that it is nearly ready to be rolled out to the launch pad. Regarding the launch pad, some final modifications will also be required after S-38 leaves the pad. The SQD frame, pipes, and ring wall mounts will need to be cleaned. Unlike previous cases, this will likely require a complete disassembly, as modifications are expected to be made to the OLM-1 pad after the 11th flight. With the Massey test site now operational, these changes can be implemented quickly. Afterward, a coating will be added to the OLM, along with various other improvements. SpaceX estimates that about a week will suffice to fully prepare the pad for the upcoming mission. All of this highlights one undeniable conclusion: the upcoming Starship flight is imminent. The focus of the 11th flight is not on record-breaking or speed-setting, but on achieving success. This success will mark the beginning of what SpaceX calls the V3 era, a crucial phase in which the company must meet new goals in preparation for future lunar and Mars missions. So express your excitement by commenting "This is it" below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel to continue following SpaceX's incredible journey, paving the way for the future of space exploration. On the other hand, regarding the launch schedule, another mission, Artemis 2, has recently attracted significant attention. Recent information indicates that NASA plans to launch the mission as early as February of next year, with the launch period possibly extending into April. The latest information was provided by Lakeisha Hawkins, currently NASA's Acting Deputy Associate Administrator for the Exploration Systems Development Mission Directorate, who stated that Artemis 2 will likely launch on February 5th. While this news is encouraging, no official announcement has been made. The launch date has not been validated on NASA's official website, and NASA reserves the right to delay the mission if potential hazards are discovered. Since Artemis 2 is a crewed mission, the safety of the astronauts will be the top priority. If this schedule remains the same, we are less than 5 months away from the first crewed lunar mission since Apollo 17, which occurred more than 50 years ago. While Artemis 2 will not land on the moon, it will orbit the celestial body with astronauts on board, demonstrating the capabilities necessary for future lunar landings. This significant achievement will yield valuable information for long-term strategy and ensure that NASA and its collaborators can safely send humans beyond low Earth orbit. An earlier launch could give NASA and commercial companies additional time to refine their technologies in preparation for Artemis 3, which aims to achieve the first crewed lunar landing. However, much work remains before Artemis 2 can fly. NASA has completed assembly of key flight components, such as the Space Launch System rocket and the Orion spacecraft. A mobile launcher has been installed, and the mobile launcher is fully ready. Astronaut training is underway, and crucial testing remains. The spacecraft will need to be transported to the launch pad for static firing tests and wet dress rehearsals, which will involve astronauts. Additionally, certain systems that experienced issues during Artemis 1, such as the Orion heat shield, will be thoroughly inspected to ensure their reliability. The road to Artemis 2 has not been easy. The program has endured several years of delays, technical difficulties, and public scrutiny. Despite these challenges, the mission is now just months away from its planned launch. Its success will not only symbolize a return to the moon, but also serve as a tangible demonstration of the achievements made possible through international cooperation and determination. Artemis 2 represents more than just a flight. It marks the beginning of a revitalized human expedition into space. Are you ready for this momentous advancement? Building on this progress, NASA has officially introduced its newest class of astronauts, a significant milestone that highlights the space agency's ambitious future plans and the exceptional skills of those who will help make them a reality. After years of careful assessment and deliberation, NASA launched its 24th astronaut group in a ceremony held on September 22nd at Johnson Space Center. This marks the first astronaut group since 2021, and it is particularly significant as humanity aims to return to the moon, establish a permanent presence there, and eventually advance to Mars. The new group consists of 10 members, evenly divided into 5 men and 5 women. They were selected from more than 8,000 applicants, all vying for one of the most challenging and prestigious positions in science and exploration. The selected individuals are Ben Bailey, Lauren Edgar, Adam Furman, Cameron Jones, Yuri Kubo, Rebecca Lawler, Anna Menon, Alda Muller, Aaron Overcash, and Catherine Spies. Among these candidates, Anna Menon may already be familiar to those interested in space. She was involved in the Polaris Dawn mission led by billionaire pilot and private astronaut Jared Isaacman, positioning her as one of the few new astronauts with prior commercial mission experience. The event served not only as a celebration, but also as a reminder of the journey ahead. Norm Knight, who heads NASA's flight operations, commended the team with a message highlighting the significance of their accomplishment. The selection process was rigorous, competitive, and extremely challenging. However, what we have before us today is a group of individuals who are not only exceptional, but who are also expected to inspire the United States and our planet. Sean Duffy, acting administrator of NASA, also addressed the candidates, emphasizing high expectations. "You represent the very best of America's talent. We will need this extraordinary talent as we have ambitious exploration plans for the future. As discussed previously, we will return to the moon with the goal of establishing a lasting presence, and what we learn from this lunar mission will propel us to Mars and beyond, into uncharted territory. He also highlighted the importance of leadership in space exploration, emphasizing that America needs to achieve its goals before competitors like China. For the new astronaut candidates, known as ASCANs, their adventure is just beginning. They will soon begin a challenging 2-year training program at Johnson Space Center, which will test their skills in a variety of areas. Their training will cover spacecraft systems, robotics, extravehicular activities, survival techniques, and physical fitness, ensuring they are ready for the many challenges that space may present. Upon completion of their training, they will be officially eligible for flight assignment. It's unlikely these newly selected astronauts will have a direct role in Artemis 3, currently planned to be the program's first crewed landing mission. However, their contributions will be crucial as NASA increases its involvement on the lunar surface, formulates a long-term exploration strategy, and develops the knowledge necessary for a mission to Mars. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.